Yeah, you have cousins. You got to go home for Thanksgiving, and people talk to you like Kevin Hart. And you going home for solace. You want family.
You're going home for peace of mind.
You going home for peace of mind.
They don't give you that. Your cousin you're not.
Your cousin in your grandma's living room saying, "Yo, man, I got this play. I want to. If you just give me, you know what I mean, $4,800, I could make you $2 million." You like, it don't work like that, man. But you got to explain to him like, life isn't like that. Money isn't free, and no one's given an opportunity. If it sounds too good to be true, it's really. And then he like, "Oh, you don't believe in the Jews."
Let me ask y'all something, because this is a real serious thing in the black community. I don't know if it happens in other communities, and if so, to what degree. But how much does a successful black person owe their family, owe people they know, owe the community, owe to the entire black race? This is some real shit. Let's say I put in all this work making myself successful. What makes people think that I owe anybody besides the people that was there since day one, or that was in the trenches, or that helped to create making me a success? Like, why do I owe anybody besides that? Be it friends, family, associates, anybody I know or anybody I don't know. Why is it that black society feels like a black person is obligated to do something for them when they didn't do anything to help establish this black person or contribute to their success in any kind of way?
Okay, what up, Smack? So I'm going to address that shit. I do this with respect because I like you, nigga, and I follow you, and I like your videos, and you seem like a cool nigga, and I got a brother in Houston, and I might run into your ass. And I don't want no problems, bro. Let me just break this down real fast, expeditiously. I did a video about this shit. Jay-Z is a fucking scumbag, because Jay-Z thinking that it doesn't work like that is bullshit when he was given opportunity. That's one. So you should always pass the buck to somebody else and pass it along. If somebody helped you and gave you a leg up, you helped them up. Russell Simmons helped you, Dame and Biggs up. Stop fucking fronting like y'all niggas had all the pull. Yeah, you had 125 grand apiece, but you didn't have no motherfucking connections. So yeah, they helped you. You helped your family. Not only that, it's one thing if a nigga's worth a couple hundred thousand or even a few million. When you're worth a billion, there are just certain things that I believe that you should do for people, at least in your family. Now, I'm not saying Jay-Z owes me shit, because he don't. I don't know the nigga. Now, I don't believe stranger black people should help other people that's black, that's strangers. Like, I don't know you. But you damn sure need to help your cousin. For $4,800, hove you a cheap, stingy-ass nigga. Now, a lot of people are going to say, "Yo, you pocket watching, you shouldn't be worried about that man's money." It's not a matter of me worrying about his money. And the answer what Smack said, that what makes him obligated to help you when you didn't help or contribute to his rise and to where he got to? Well, I'm assuming if a nigga is asking you for $4,800, he probably didn't have shit when you was starting at your inception of your rap career, which is why he need to be helped out, because he been fucked up for 21 years or however long Jay-Z been rapping. God damn, he been fucked up since 1995. Help the nigga out. It ain't that hard. But we as people, as black people, have a fucking ego problem, which is why other people, the Asians, the Arabs, the whites, look at us and think we're fucking stupid. Even African niggas. The African niggas see this stupid shit and is like, "You know what? I would help six of my fucking family members in the same house. Akon did." We the only stupid motherfuckers that don't. Mexico, you think a Mexican motherfucker worth $1 billion gonna sit back and watch his Jose ask him for $4,800 and gonna be like, "Nah, it doesn't work like that, Holmes. I can't help you." No, I don't give a fuck if he uses this for bad. But the least you can say after he uses the money, "I did help you. Now you did bad with it. I'm not helping you again." But we so fucking stupid that we want to say, "Nah, it don't work like that." Like, we don't even know, like, nigga done laid out a plan on what he about to do with $4,800. Are you, like, I'm still bringing, it's bringing me back to that shit, because I'm not a billionaire and that's not a lot of money. Like, if I had the means to give a nigga $4,800, I fucking would. Even if you do fucked up shit with it, at the very least, I can say, yo, I helped you. You fucked it up. You squandered it. Now I'm not doing nothing more. But I don't think Jay-Z even helped that nigga, which makes him a fucking scumbag. And we need to have more fucking communal type of principles within our culture. That's why it's fucked up right now, because we have too many egotistical, stingy, selfish, dumb motherfuckers in the culture. And then we got people that question, should a nigga help? Yeah, we wouldn't have this fucking problem if Tupac was around. That's why he's more impactful. So you niggas just know how to keep... Look, it, I ain't got the most money, but there's a fucking famous saying that a person that helps you out when they got it, that's a fucking favor. A person that helps you out when they don't got it, that's love. I've helped niggas out when I didn't even have it. That's fucking love. Now, if we could do more than that, we'd have a lot. But we so fucking stupid that we think that if we help a nigga, that he gonna fuck up the money, and we ain't, like, we thinking negative from the jump. And I understand that, yeah, some black people gonna burn you. But it's a nigga asking for $4,800 and you a billionaire. The fact that you said no makes you a fucking stingy cheapskate. Anyways, this shit was long and long-winded, and I had to address this even though I fucks with Smack Water. Hope the nigga, yeah, don't call me no cake ass nigga, because I ain't no whole ass nigga either. But I had to address this. In any event, I'm out. No one's